Okay, look. So one sec. Let's understand what Nike is firstly, yeah? Nike is a Greek goddess of victory. Nike is the Greek goddess of victory. Okay? It's an idol that was worshipped besides Allah. It's a taghut. It's a false god that was worshipped besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And waftarad Allahu ala jamil al-ibad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made obligatory upon all of his slaves al-kufra bit-taghut, that we disbelieve in all false gods. Wal-imana billah, and we believe in only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That makes sense. Now, the discussion is, Nike, the brand, did they take any influence from the Greek goddess? And yes, they did, 100%. It used to be called Blue Ribbon Sports, that was the name of the company before. And online, on the Business Insider, there was an interview that was done with the CEOs of Nike and the chairman of Nike, the people basically run it. And they mentioned the story of when they changed the name from Blue Ribbon Sports to Nike. The person was head of the marketing department, the branding department. He came up with his name Nike, and he said it is from the Greek goddess of victory. It's from the Greek goddess of victory. Does that make sense? So when they wear Nike, what they're wearing is the name, and the tick now has become a symbol that represents the name. Sahih? If you saw a tick on the wall, you'd come and you didn't see Nike written, you'd say, "Rah, who put the Nike tick there?" Would you not say that? Straight away you say that, right? Because straight away you associate the tick with the name and the name with the tick. The two are now inseparable. So now pay attention. Here's where it gets scary. Would you wear a cross? Would you wear a cross? Would you wear a jumper that had a big fat cross in the middle?
No.
You wouldn't wear it. It had a crucifix, yeah? Not just any cross, but I'm talking about a crucifix. You wouldn't wear that, right? You wouldn't wear that. So, because you know it's a symbol of shirk and kufr. You know it's an article of disbelief. Would you wear a medallion that had the Ganesh? You know the elephant that the Hindus worship? Would you wear a little medallion that had the Ganesh on there? Would you wear that? You wouldn't wear that, right? There's no difference between you wearing a crucifix to wearing a statue to wearing Nike. It's all the same thing. Each one of them represents false gods that were worshipped besides Allah. Whether that god is worshipped till today or not, whether that god is still worshipped today or not is irrelevant. Do atheists celebrate Christmas? Yes, they do. It's become a commercial holiday. But it's still a day that represents kufr and shirk, the day when the Son of God was born, right? So, look, brothers, there's a discussion that's going on right now. Some people will tell you wearing Nike is okay. Some people will tell you, no, it's haram. And this is the view that we are inclined to. My question is this. Do you want to die? Do you want the angel of death to come take your soul? And you're wearing the name of another god on your chest? I'm scared for you. I'm scared for myself if I die in that way. That when they bury me, when they come to me, when the paramedics come and they pick up my dead body, where they have to strip off me, Nike shoes, Nike hoodie, Nike this, Nike that. And brothers claim to be Salafi, huh? They claim Salafiyah. Look at me, I'm on a path and a manhaj of the Salaf al-Salih. What is from the most primary things of this manhaj? What is it? At-Tawheed, right? That's the most primary thing from this manhaj. At-Tawheed. The fact that you know there was a god once called Nike. How can you bring yourself to be wearing this? The hadith Ustaz Rahman mentioned earlier, hadith Sunan al-Bayhaqi. The Prophet said, "Awthaqu 'ur al-iman," that the highest branch of iman is al-hubbu fillah wal-bughdu fillah. It's love for the sake of Allah and hate for the sake of Allah. You're supposed to hate shirk and kufr. You're supposed to hate it. How can you bring yourself to do that? Does that make sense? And wallahi, I'm saying for an article of clothing, people want to go hellfire for the smallest things. The guys who don't want to grow their beards, they tell you, "Oh, it's okay, I don't have to grow it, there's difference of opinion." I'm saying for a few strands of hair, you want to go to the hellfire? Guys who don't want to wear the trousers below their ankle, they say, "It's okay, I can wear it below my ankle." They don't want to wear it above the ankle, they want to wear it below. Because they say difference of opinion. And that difference of opinion is not taken, because it's not valid. It goes against clear-cut textual evidences. But do you want to go to hell? Because the Prophet said, whatever is below the ankle is in the hellfire. So you want to risk hellfire for a few inches of garment? Garment? Sisters who want the curse of Allah because they pluck their eyebrows. For a few plucks, few strands of hair, you want to get the curse of Allah? Want to get a curse of Allah? It's a problem, isn't it? It's a problem. The Prophet ﷺ once saw a companion who was wearing a cross. Adi ibn Hatim, radiallahu anhu, if I'm not mistaken. And he came from Christianity to Islam. He told him, take it off. He told him, take it off. So the same way the Prophet ﷺ removed that article of shirk that he was wearing from him, if you're wearing an article of shirk, you have to also remove it now. The Prophet said, إِنَّ الْحَلَالَ بَيِّنْ. Verily the halal is clear. وَإِنَّ الْحَرَامَ بَيِّنْ. And the haram is clear. وَبَيْنَهُمَا مُشْتَبِهَاتٍ. And then between the halal and the haram, there are things that you might feel like, I don't know which one they fall into right now. I'm still unsure. Is Nike halal? Is it haram? I don't know. So then what did the Prophet advise you? If you are there right now and you're like, I don't know. Brother Imran, what you said hasn't convinced me. You haven't convinced me that it's haram. So I'm still kind of confused. Is it halal or haram? Then take the advice that the Prophet gave. He said, فَمَنْ اتَّقَ الشُّبُهَاتِ اسْتَبْرَعَ لِدِينِهِ وَعِرْضِهِ وَمَنْ وَقَعَ فِي الشُّبُهَاتِ وَقَعَ فِي الْحَرَامِ. Stay away from the ones that you're unclear about. Because whoever stays away from the unclear matters, he stays away from the haram. Because if you keep going to the things that you're not sure about, because you're not sure, eventually you're going to fall into haram, right? So just stay far away from it. Wallahi, I just asked you all a question. Brothers, on the day of judgment, at the time your angel of death comes, do you want him to come when you're wearing Nike? Wallahi, I'll be scared. Wallahi, I'll be so scared that I'm wearing the name of another God. A'udhu billah. And if you don't see the severity of that, then wallahi, you don't understand La ilaha illallah the way you should. You don't understand La ilaha illallah the way you should. So inshallah, I would advise you to be how the Sahaba were. The Sahabiyat, the female companions. We always tell the sisters, cover up, wear hijab, fear Allah. Brothers, you might need to fear. She's not wearing a hijab. She's not doing shirk. She's not come with minor shirk. She's come with disobedience. Major disobedience. But she's not come with shirk. The brother who's wearing Nike, telling the sister, hey, cover up. He's wearing Nike. He's got shirk on him. He's wearing shirk. So you take the advice first before you come and say, oh, the way the female companions were, the moment the ayah of hijab came down, they ripped off the extra garment and they covered their head with it. You take that advice. The moment you hear Nike is haram, take it off. Take it off. Take it off. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows best. Brothers, inshallah, just before we end, I just want to mention that we have a program here, inshallah ta'ala, that we're going to be doing on the 3rd of July. A student of knowledge program, inshallah. We're going to be going through the syllabus that's taught in Masjid Nabawi. There's going to be 4 books that are studied. The 10 nullifiers of Islam, the 4 principles of shirk, the 3 questions in the grave, and the 40 hadith of Imam an-Nawawi, which summarize the entire religion. Whoever finishes this program, passes the test, will get an ijazah, an official certification from Masjid an-Nabawi in Medina. From Masjid an-Nabawi in Medina. From the scholar, Sheikh Abu Masa al-Qasim, who set that syllabus, going back up to the scholars who wrote those books, who offered those books. So you'll get a chain to Imam an-Nawawi. You'll get a chain to Sheikh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahab for the books that you studied that he wrote. Inshallah ta'ala, spaces are very limited. There was 200 spaces altogether, 100 for brothers, 100 for sisters. Over 120 spaces are already gone. If you guys want to sign up.
We had the biggest supply of these books. They're very rare, very hard to find. And we're not giving them out just like that. You have to be serious. You have to show that you're committed. You actually want to seek this knowledge. You have to memorize it, inshallah ta'ala. And guess what? We also have the biggest supply probably in the West of all the other levels as well. There's 5-6 levels altogether, alhamdulillah. Every year, every summer, we're gonna come back, we're gonna go to the next level, inshallah ta'ala, and we're gonna work our way up to the top until we all grow together, solid, strong, master all these key foundational books that will allow us to benefit ourselves and to teach the ummah and to be able to defend the religion from the kuffar and the mubtadi'ah who attack it, the innovators who attack it in terms of the aqidah of this religion. We'll be able to defend it as well, inshallah ta'ala. And, you know, as they say, the rest is history. So this is our mission. In order to revive knowledge in a systematic way. We've got, alhamdulillah, this supply of books from Masjid Nabawi. We're able to, inshallah ta'ala, provide official certification, inshallah ta'ala. And all we need from you is to commit throughout the summer, 2 days a week. If you would like to register, there's only 100 spaces for brothers and only 100 spaces for sisters. You need to go to the link below, inshallah ta'ala, and register ASAP because time's running out, spaces are running out. Inshallah, we'll see you in the Masjid in West London where we're going to be teaching this, studying, memorizing. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Peace.